गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
ओके, सो इन द मॉर्निंग सेशन वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी एंड द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी एंड व्हाट यू मीन बाय मोबिलिटी एंड ऑल. ओके, सो रिजा, कैन यू डिफाइन मोबिलिटी?
मोबिलिटी इज डिफाइंड एज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी पर यूनिट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड.
That's very good. Mobility is the magnitude of drift velocity per unit electric field, and the equation is, and how we can represent mobility using which letter, Gauri?
Mu.
Mu. All right. And mu is equal to Vd by E. So then, what is drift velocity? What is drift velocity? Malavika, what do you mean by drift velocity?
Minus E capital E by m into tau.
Yes, minus small letter e capital E tau by m is known as the drift velocity. Can you define drift velocity, Diya? Definition for drift velocity.
It is the velocity that is possessed by electrons which is drifted towards the positive side.
Yes, it is the velocity that is possessed by the electrons when it is drifted from negative to positive side in the presence of electric field is known as drift velocity. The velocity possessed by the electron in the absence of electric field is known as thermal velocity. So that is the difference between thermal velocity and drift velocity. So now we can move to the next topic, that is the relation between current and drift velocity. So all of you write the heading, relation between current and drift velocity. Relation between current and drift velocity. How we can represent drift velocity? How we represent drift velocity? Vd. Okay. So what is the relation between current and drift velocity? So this is the derivation. We want to find a relation between current and drift velocity. For that, first of all, we consider a conductor. Consider a conductor. All of you write the condition that we are taken here. In order to make a relation between current and drift velocity, consider a conductor with a length L and area of cross section A. To make a relation between current and drift velocity, suppose we are consider a conductor with a length L and area of cross section A. Now this conductor is connected to an external electric field. This conductor is connected to an external electric field. Due to the presence of this positive and negative terminal of the electric field, one side of the conductor is become positive and the other side is becomes negative. So here we are conductor. We are considering a conductor with a length L and area of cross section A. Then we are connecting this conductor to an external electric field. Due to the presence of this positive and negative terminal of this electric field, one side of the conductor is become positive and the other side is become negative. Then the volume of the conductor is given by, the volume of conductor is equal to, the volume of the conductor is equal to area into length, area of the conductor into the length of the conductor. Or we can write volume. You must write it volume instead of V. Sometimes you may have a tendency to write it velocity. So you must write it volume. Volume is equal to the area of the conductor is A, and what is the length? L. So the volume is A into L, or volume is equal to AL. So here we are consider a conductor with a length L and area of cross section A. and we are connecting it to an external electric field. Due to the presence of this positive and negative terminal of the electric field, one end of the conductor is become positive and other end is become negative. Then we are find an expression for the volume of the conductor. The volume of the conductor is given by the product of area and the length of the conductor. And here we are take the area as A and the length of the conductor as L. Therefore, volume is equal to A into L, that is equal to AL. Now, let N be the number of electrons present in the conductor. This conductor consisting of charge carriers. And inside the case of a, in the case of a conductor, we know that the free electron is act as a charge carrier. Let N be the number of charge carriers present in the conductor. Capital letter N. Let N be the number of charge carriers present in the conductor. Then the number of electrons, the number of electrons per unit volume, the number of electrons per unit volume gives the number density N. This is a new term for you, the number density, small letter N. Capital letter N is the number of electrons present in a conductor, and the number of electrons present per unit volume of the conductor is known as number density. It is represented by small letter N, or we can write N is equal to capital letter N divided by volume, where this small letter N is represents the number density and capital N represents the number of electrons present in the conductor. Both are different. Okay. And the number of electrons present in the conductor per unit volume is known as number density. It is represented by the letter, small letter N. So here we have N is equal to capital letter N divided by volume. Or we can write N is equal to capital letter N divided by, what is the equation for calculating the volume of the conductor? What is the volume of the present conductor? Yes, it is AL. Say it louder. N is equal to AL. The volume of the conductor is given by the product of area into length. That is, volume is equal to AL. So we can write N is equal to capital N divided by AL, because this conductor is with a length L and area of cross section, and hence the volume of conductor is nothing, it is the product of area and the length. That is what is we are starting. So small letter N is equal to capital N divided by AL. So from this equation we can write capital N is equal to, just to rearrange the equation, capital N is equal to capital, yes, small N into AL. Capital N is equal to small N AL. Okay. But here we want to make a relation between current and drift velocity. So write the next statement. The current passing through the conductor is given by, the current passing through the conductor is given by, current through the conductor is given by, what is the equation for calculating the current? I is equal to equation for calculating the current. The current that is passing through the conductor is given by I. I is equal to, yes, Achyut, unmute and answer. I is equal to, yes, I is equal to Q by T. That is, we know that electric current is nothing. It is the rate of flow of charge. So I is equal to Q by T. But we know that according to quantization, what is Q? According to the quantization of charge, that is, we were discussed in the first chapter, one of the property of the charge. Charge is the product of number of electrons into charge of the electron. That is Q is equal to Ne. Did you remember this equation? According to quantization, we know that the charge Q is equal to Ne, where N is the number of electron and E is the charge of electron. But in the present case, what is the number of electrons? What is the number of electrons present in the given conductor?
Two.
What is the number of electrons present in the conductor in the present case? N, capital letter N. So here we can write Q is equal to N into small e. So the current passing through the conductor is given by I is equal to Q by T, where I is the electric current, Q is the charge, and T is the time. But according to the quantization of charge, we know that Q is equal to Ne. Q is equal to Ne. Now we can substitute the value of Q in this equation. So the current, the equation for current becomes Ne divided by T. I is equal to Ne divided by T. So instead of the charge Q, according to the quantization, we know that Q is equal to Ne. We just substitute the value of Q here. So I is equal to Ne divided by T. Now, what is the number of electrons? Here we have I is equal to Ne divided by T. What is the equation for calculating N? N is equal to small nAl, right? N is equal to small nAl. So we can substitute the value of capital letter N here. Therefore, the value of the current I become small nAl into E divided by T. So I is equal to nAle divided by T. Now, once again, we can rearrange the equation. It becomes I is equal to nAe into L by T. Just to rearrange the equation, we have I is equal to nAle divided by T. So just rearranging these terms, we get the current I is equal to nAe into L divided by T, where N is the number density and A is the area of cross section, E is the charge of the electron, and L by T, where L is the length, we can take it as displacement, and T is the time. Can you recall what you mean by displacement by time? The rate of change of displacement is known as
velocity.
Velocity, very good. So here the L by T is nothing. It is the displacement by time. That is the rate of change of displacement with respect to time is known as velocity V. So instead of writing L by T, we can substitute it as V. Here the length by time, that is the displacement by time, is nothing. It is our V. So the expression for current become I is equal to NAe into V. And in this case, this velocity is nothing. It is our drift velocity. That is the velocity acquired by the electrons in order to drift from this negative terminal to the positive terminal. So instead of writing the symbol V, we can mark it as VD. This velocity is nothing. This is our drift velocity. It is the velocity acquired by the electron in the presence of electric field. In the presence of electric field, it is drifted from negative side to positive side. So I is equal to NAe into VD. So this is the relation between electric current and that of the drift velocity. The electric current I is equal to NAe into VD. I will give you a trick to study this in order to remember this equation. During my school days, I have a tendency to study using mnemonics. So we can arrange like the order A, B, E, N. How it is read? oven, right? So I is equal to oven. You can use that trick to remember the equation. This is the expression for the relation between electric current and that of the drift velocity. The same equation, we just rearrange it. So you just skip this letter D. So we get a relation between current and that of the drift velocity. I is equal to AVDEL. What is A represents? A represents in this equation, what is A? A is the area of cross section. What is VD? VD is the drift velocity. And what is E represent? Charge of the electron. And N? N is a new term. N is the number density. N is the number density. It's a new term for you. That is the number of electrons present per unit volume of the conductor. So you can use, any way you can write this equation like this. This is the relation between the current and drift velocity. I is equal to AVDE into N. Okay. Now I will introduce a new term, another new term. So after this you can write, but the current that is flowing per unit area is given by the current density J. The current flowing per unit area. The current flowing per unit area is the current density. How we can represent the current density? Current density J. So the current flowing per unit area is the current density J. Or we can write the current density J is equal to current that is flowing per unit area. So that is I divided by A, the current density. But the current density J, that is the current flowing per unit area, is given by I divided by A. Now we can substitute the value of current here. Then what is the value of J? J is equal to, the equation for calculating I is AVEN, that is AVDEN divided by A. So here we can cancel this area and this area from numerator and denominator. So finally we get J is equal to VD E into N, that is the drift velocity into charge of the electron into the number density, is given the current density J. Okay, but what is the expression for drift velocity VD? What is the equation for calculating the drift velocity VD? Ah, yes, Gayatri, unmute and answer. It's right.
Minus E, tau by.
Okay, E, capital E, tau by M is the expression for the drift velocity. Here we have a negative sign. We can skip that negative sign because that negative sign is only indicate the direction of the electric field and that of the electrons. So the equation for VD is small letter E, capital E, tau by M. Then the current density J becomes E capital E tau by M into small letter E into N. Just substitute the value of drift velocity here. Here the current density J is equal to VD into small letter E into N. We know that the expression for drift velocity E tau by M, it has a negative sign, but that negative sign is only indicate the direction of the electric field and the that of the electron. So we can just neglect it. So the J is equal to small e capital E tau E N divided by M. Or we can write J is equal to N E square tau E divided by M. J is equal to E into E, it becomes E square. N E square tau E divided by M. Okay. So here we get an expression for the current density. J is equal to N E square Cho into E divided by M. What is N represent here? N is the number density. Okay. And what is E represents? Charge of the electron. Cho is the, what is Cho?
Relaxation
time. Very good. Cho is the relaxation time. And what is M? M is the mass of the electron. So here, the number density, N is a constant. The number density, that is the number of electrons per present per unit volume. That is N divided by L. It is a constant. Similarly, E, it is the charge of the electron. It is a constant. Similarly, the relaxation time, tau, is also a constant because all these processes are takes place under a particular time. The successive two collisions are takes place at a constant time. So tau is a constant and the mass of the electron is also a constant. Okay, so here in this equation, the number density, charge of the electron, relaxation time and mass of the electron, these much terms are constant. And that constant is entirely equal to sigma, or we can write J is equal to sigma E, where sigma is a constant and its value can be calculated by sigma is equal to N E square tau divided by M. Here this entire term of this equation is a constant. That constant is equal to sigma and that constant is known as conductivity of the conductor. This constant sigma is known as conductivity of the conductor. Okay, so the current density, that is the current that is flowing per a unit area, can be given by J is equal to N E square tau by M into E. But this N E square tau by M in that equation is a constant. That constant is, we are equating it to another constant that is equal to sigma. That constant sigma is known as conductivity of the conductor. It is known as the conductivity of the conductor. And the conductivity of a conductor is defined as, the conductivity of a conductor is defined as, or it is the measure of, conductivity of a conductor is the measure of how the electric current is moves within a, how the electric current is moves within a substance. The conductivity of the conductor is the measure of how the electric current is moves within a substance. So in the present slide, we can see the relation between the current and the drift velocity. We are starting it with the expression for I. I is equal to Q by T. Before that, we have the volume. Volume V is equal to, what is the equation for volume? Volume of the conductor. The volume of the conductor is calculated by area into L, length. So the volume is equal to AL. Then let N be the number of electrons present in the conductor. So the small letter N, the number density N is equal to capital N divided by volume. Or we have N is equal to capital N divided by AL, which implies N is equal to small n AL. Then we are just to substitute these values to the equation for current. I is equal to Q by T, but we know that Q is according to quantization, it is NE divided by T. Then substitute the value of N here. it becomes I is equal to N A L E divided by T. So from this step onwards, you can find here on this slide. N A E L divided by T, and from this equation L by T is nothing, it is the velocity, and that velocity in the present case it is the drift velocity. So the current I is equal to N A E into V D, or we can write I is equal to V D E N A. Also the current I by A is equal to V D or E N, and we are making a relation between the current and that of the current density J. The J is given as VDEN. And what is the definition for current density? Current density is the electric current per unit cross sectional area of the conductor, and the current density is given by current divided by area. That is J is equal to I by A. And this current density is equal to sigma E. The constant of proportionality sigma is known as the conductivity of the conductor, and the conductivity of the conductor is nothing, it is the measure of how the electric current is moves through a substance. Is it clear? Yes. Okay, can we move to the next topic? The next topic is Ohm's law. All of you write the next heading, Ohm's law. So before that, Sania, can you recall the relation between current and that of the drift velocity? What is the equation which connecting the current and that of the drift velocity? Unmute and answer. Yes. Ashwin, what is the relation between drift velocity and current? All of you, please switch on your video. Yes, Sania, what is the relation which is connecting the current and that of the drift velocity? Equation only. Unmute and answer.
Ma'am, I'm not able to recollect.
Ah, yes?
I'm not able to recollect.
Okay. Meenakshi?
I is equal to N A E V D.
Okay. I is equal to N A V D into E. Okay. All right. So, what is the equation that is connecting the current density and that of the electric field? Anna. Current density and that of the electric field.
VDEN.
That is current density. What is the final equation? Current density, conductivity, and that of the electric field.
E small E E N E square dou by M.
Equation connecting the current density, conductivity, and that of the electric field. J, sigma, and E. What is the equation connecting the conductivity, current density, and that of the electric field? Rijaf?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the equation connecting the current density, conductivity, and that of the electric field?
J is equal to sigma into E.
J is equal to sigma into E. Okay. Adul, what do you mean by current density then?
What is the current per unit area?
Current per unit area. Okay. Achyut?
Yes, ma'am.
Conductivity. What do you mean by conductivity?
Conductivity of the conductor.
Ah, yes, conductivity of the conductor.
Measure of how the electric current moves within a substance.
It is the measure of how the electric current is moves within a substance, and how we can represent this conductivity? Using which letter? sigma. Sigma is used to represent the conductivity. So now we can move to the next topic, that is Ohm's law. Ohm's law. I know that you are already studied this Ohm's law in the 10th standard. So can you recall this Ohm's law? Anybody? Yeah. Emmanuel, have you heard the Ohm's law?
I heard it before.
Yes, it's a Greek scientist named Grigory Simon Ohm is introduced this Ohm's law. And we were already discussed about the current I and the voltage V. So the relation between the current and this voltage or the potential V is given by this Ohm's law. So in order to explain this Ohm's law, suppose we can consider a conductor. Let's suppose this resistor is act as a conductor. It is connected to a battery or a cell. And here an ammeter. For what purpose we are using this ammeter? Yes, what is the use of ammeter? Yes, not charge. Ammeter is used to measure the current through a circuit. So ammeter is connected here, and ammeter is always connected series to a circuit. And a voltmeter is also attached to here in order to measure the voltage. Okay. So according to Ohm's law, the Ohm's law stated that the potential difference across the ends of a conductor. Here we have a conductor. The potential difference that is across the ends of a conductor V is directly proportional to the current that is flowing through the conductor. So this is what is the Ohm's law state. The potential difference across the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current that is flowing through a conductor under one condition. What is that condition? Temperature remains constant. Okay. So when the temperature remains constant, the potential difference across the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor. Or we can write V is directly proportional to I. In order to replace this proportionality sign, here we are introduced a constant. We can write V is equal to R into I. Or you are studying V is equal to IR. This equation is known as Ohm's law. V is equal to IR, where V is the potential, I is the current, and R is the proportionality constant. And that proportionality constant, R is known as resistance. R is known as the resistance of the conductor. Okay. So what is Ohm's law? Ohm's law stated that under the constant temperature, the potential difference across the ends of the conductor is directly proportional to the current that is flowing through the conductor. This is what is the Ohm's law. I will show the slide. Okay. So Ohm's law states that the current I in a resistor is proportional to the potential difference V across it, provided that the temperature of the object is a constant. Okay. So here the condition that we are must maintain that the temperature of the object must be kept constant. Then only we can satisfy this equation, that is the potential difference V is directly proportional to I. In order to replace this proportionality sign, here we are introduced a constant, and that constant of proportionality is known as what? The constant of proportionality is known as
resistance.
That is V is directly proportional to I. V is directly proportional to I. According to this statement, the potential difference V is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor, or V is equal to R into I, or we can write V is equal to IR. This is the equation for Ohm's law, and where R is known as the resistance. And what do you mean by resistance? Resistance is a property which opposes the flow of current through a circuit. So what do you mean by resistance? Resistance is a property which opposes the flow of current through a circuit. So resistance is the opposition that an electrical device has to the flow of electric current. So the resistance is a property which opposes the flow of electric current through a circuit. And the unit of resistance is known as ohm. Unit of resistance is ohm because it is introduced by G.S. Ohm. In order to honor him, the resistance, the unit of the resistance is known as ohm, and it is represented by this letter. Okay. So instead of writing ohm, you can use this symbol. In order to write the value of resistance, for example, if it is 48 ohm, you can write 48 and write the symbol, draw the symbol of resistance. Unit of resistance is ohm. So resistance is nothing. It is the opposition of the flow of the current through a circuit, and its unit is given by ohm. It is represented by this letter. Okay. And every object, every substance or every conductor is possess its own resistance value. It is a constant for that particular substance. For example, if the copper is possess a resistance of 20 ohm, then the nichrome sometimes it possess a resistance of 22 ohm and all. Okay. So all devices have some resistance, and resistor is a device that has a particular resistance. Every device is possess a particular value for the resistance. Okay. Now we are going to derive this Ohm's law. So you can write the heading deduction of Ohm's law or derivation of Ohm's law. Next heading, derivation of Ohm's law. Okay, derivation of Ohm's law. We know that according to Ohm's law, V is directly proportional to I, or V is equal to IR. What is the equation for calculating the current? What is the expression for current in a conductor? The relation between current and that of the drift velocity. Current I is equal to the mnemonics AVEN. AVDEN. This is the expression for calculating the current in a conductor. If there is an electric field is present, then the relation between the current and the drift velocity is given by I is equal to AVDEN. Then what is VD? Expression for VD is nothing. It is capital E, small letter E into capital E, tau divided by M. This is the expression for the drift velocity VD. Then I is equal to, instead of VD, we can write this value, A into small e, capital E, tau by M into the remaining terms, that is E into N. Or by rearranging, we get I is equal to N e square A e tau by M. So here we get I is equal to N e square A e into tau divided by M. But the electric field E is equal to, but the electric field is equal to V divided by L. But here the electric field E is given as V by L. So instead of E, we can write V by L, wherein I is equal to N E square A. Instead of E, we have V divided by L into tau. Or by rearranging, we can write I is equal no. to I S.
Divide by M.
Ah, yes. M also here. Or we can write I is equal to N E square A tau divided by M into V by L. We just rearrange the same equation. I is equal to N E square A tau by M into V by L. Now from this equation, can you make an equation for V? The potential voltage V. From this equation, V is equal to the L and M become the numerator. Yes. L M divided by N E square A tau into I. Yes. Oh.
No, I was asking about the I.
I is here. Okay. So here L is the length of the conductor, M is the mass, N is the number density, E is the charge of the electron, and A is the area of cross section of the conductor. Tau is the relaxation time. All these constants, all these terms are constant, where L is the length, M is the mass of the electron, N is the number density, E is the charge of the electron, and A is the area of cross section, and tau is the relaxation time. All these terms are constant, and that constant is equal to the resistance. So here L M divided by N E square A tau is equal to a constant, and that constant is equal to R. So we can write V is equal to R into I. This is the way the Ohm's law is derived. V is equal to R into I. Okay. So here we have R. What is R? The equation for R is equal to L divided by, not L, R is equal to M divided by N E square tau into L by A. Okay, we need this equation. So you can start here. V is equal to, we can stop here. V is equal to R into I. So this is the derivation of Ohm's law. Once again, I will show this derivation of Ohm's law. We are starting from the drift velocity. So here we have the equation V is proportional to I, or V is equal to RI or IR. This is the Ohm's law. So in order to derive this equation, we are starting it from the drift velocity. Not drift velocity, it is starting from the expression, the relation between current and drift velocity, that is I is equal to 7. Okay. But the expression for drift velocity Vd is equal to small e capital E tau by M. So we substitute the value of Vd here. Then it becomes I is equal to A into E capital E tau divided by M into En, or we can write I is equal to N E square A E tau divided by M. Then what happens here? The electric field E is equal to V by L. So the equation for I becomes I is equal to N E square A into tau by M. Instead of this E, we are substituting as V divided by L. Or we can write I is equal to, and from this equation we make a expression for V. V is equal to I into LM divided by N E square A tau. This LM N E square A tau, this entire term is a constant. And this constant is equal to R, that is what is known as the resistance of the conductor. So we can write V is equal to IR, V equal to IR, where R is equal to LM divided by N E square A tau. R is equal to LM divided by N E square A tau. Is it clear? The derivation of Ohm's law. We are starting from the expression for the relation between the current and drift velocity. Then we substitute the value of drift velocity in that equation. And just rearranging, we get V is equal to IR. That is V is equal to I into LM divided by N E square A tau, where L is the length, M is the mass, N is the number density, E is the charge of the electron, A is the area of cross-section of the conductor, and tau is the relaxation time. This entire term is a constant, and that constant is equal to R, that is the resistance of the conductor. So we can write V is equal to IR. This equation is the equation of Ohm's law. Okay, so according to Ohm's law, the potential difference across the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current I. In order to replace this proportionality constant, we are introduce a constant. That constant is known as the resistance R. So the resistance of a conductor is nothing. It is the property which is opposes the flow of current through a conductor, and its unit is given by Ohm. The unit of the resistance is given as Ohm. So we can write V is equal to IR. This is the equation of Ohm's law. Is it clear? So here today we are discussing about the relation between current and drift velocity. I is equal to AVDEN, Avan. Then here we are deriving the Ohm's law. So you must state the Ohm's law first. Ohm's law is the potential difference across the ends of a conductor is directly proportional to the current that is flowing through the conductor under the constant temperature. That is, V is proportional to I, or V is equal to IR. And here now we are derive the expression for the Ohm's law with the help of the relation between current and drift velocity. Okay, I hope this topic is clear, right? Do you have any doubt in this topic? Okay, so with this we can wind up the session. Thank you, and we can meet on the next period. Okay, bye. Thank you all.
Thank you.